How close? How close were those jets together? Now, before we answer, I want you to think about this for a second. My canopy was right here. The wingtip of my wingman was how many feet away? Give me some guesses. How many? 6, 5 inches. 1. Okay. Good, good, good. All right. Yeah. 36 inches. Okay. 36 inches. And that's where we started. We got closer every day. Talk about continuous improvement. Okay. We started the year at 36 inches. We got down to 18 inches. All right. Now, let me give you a chance to experience what that might feel like. First off, reach out your arms. Reach out your arms. Okay, look at the end of those fingertips. Now, first off, if there's somebody at the end of those fingertips, how much do you trust them? All right, keep your arms up. Keep your arms up. Can you imagine at the end of these fingertips is a 22-ton jet going 400 knots upside down? I mean, how do you do that? I mean, how do you reach a level of excellence, precision, teamwork, and probably more relevant, is that important to you? In sales, distribution, marketing, operations, supply chain. I'm going to let you make that decision. But here's the objective today. What I'm going to do is take you on a ride, a high-performance climb. And we're going to go inside, behind the scenes of an elite high-performance organization. Going to happen to use the Blue Angels. But we're going to give you a first-hand experience of not only what it was like to fly. It's not going to be about flying today. What we're going to do is we're going to break it down. And we're going to say, what are those critical processes? What are those critical skills? And probably most important, what are the critical thinking skills that were needed to operate at that level of precision and excellence? And then most importantly, we'll build the bridge to you. How can you take those lessons and use them not only in your personal life, but in your teams and your organization? That's how I want you to rate me today, if we're able to make that connection. Today, we're going into what I call the higher performance zone. And what's that? What's the high performance zone? Okay, this is a place you operate in every single day. You know this very well, because it's simply the gap between where you are and where you want to go. It's that simple. Speaking of gaps, I know you got a gap team. It's the difference between where you are and where you want to go. If you want to measure that in margin, 2, 4, 6, or 15%. If you want to measure it in sales. If you want to measure it in profitability. You can define the gap. Now, what I'm going to do today is share with you a framework. A framework that I've found is the most powerful way to close that gap in performance.